Hello! She's alright. I'm back. I'm just sitting at my... Come on. Things. Oh, the internet. The joys of the internet. How are we all? We are playing Herzog Zwei. It is on the Megadrive. Very exciting. Just want to make sure I'm muted. Yes, I am. So yes, Herzog Zwei. Why am I playing this? Why am I so excited about playing this game? But also some changes to the channel, visually and audio-wise. I'm hoping significant improvements. So previously I had a little clip-on microphone. It wasn't really working well. There was lots of distortion, so that wasn't working out for me at all. And then the other thing I had was the screen. So I've actually got rid of the big grey border, which I think was taking up too much of the screen, and just put most of the screen now over to the actual game itself, which I should have done in the first place. Apologies for that. But anyway, it's much better now. It's cleaner. And I'm using my Snowball microphone, so hopefully the audio, my audio is much, much better. I did have it before, but it was too far away from my face, and it was echoey, so I gave up. But now I've got this... I've always had this boom thing, but you know, it's now... there. So, yes, Herzog Zwei, why we're playing this is the world's first, I believe, RTS. There was, now this game is called Herzog Zwei for a reason. It's Zwei being German for two, for those of you who are familiar with that language, and that means there was the first one, and there was. There was a first one, way back when, in 1988. This game came out in 89, so about a year later. This has come out for the Mega Drive exclusively, so it's exclusive title on the Mega Drive. But there was a previous game on the MSX2 called Herzog, just simply Herzog. It's not really like this game. There are some similarities, of course, because they're both... but there's not really an RTS game. It's a different kind of beast. So yeah, we're not playing the MSX2 game, we're playing, and that's a Japanese game by the way, so we wouldn't know what's going on anyway. So here they are, TechnoSoft made it in 1989, so the previous one, I think it might have come out in 87 actually, looking back, but there it is. So, how does it work? What's it do? This is an RTS stroke MOBA from 1989. That's a long time ago, 28 years ago. So, What gives? How is it an RTS? Well, first thing, you do actually command units, but these units you can't actually directly control. You just simply generate them and then drop them into place and hope they do what they're supposed to do. So in that case, it's like they're all automated. It's very much like a MOBA in that regard, in that they're automated units. You create them and then they just go and do things depending on what you told them to do in the first place. I don't believe you can tell them to do anything else. Once you've dropped them in place, that's what they're going to do. Nothing else. The game starts with you in a map, in one corner of the map. There's another side, so in this they've got a split screen. Normally it's a two-player game, actually. We have the split screen, and you can see what the other person's doing. But I'm going to be playing a single player, obviously. I will be playing it on my original Mega Drive. This is not my original Mega Drive, sorry. This is a refurbished Mega Drive. I do have two. My original one is actually, you probably can just see it just behind me. It's in the Tower of Power. And, someone chat. Hey, Real Sergeant Crispy. Hello, Real Sergeant Crispy. You can actually turn. He's telling me how to play the game. Thank you, Sergeant. I appreciate it. Okay, so this is going to be really embarrassing because I've only played this game for about a couple of hours and I'm rubbish at it. Which is really makes perfect sense because I'm rubbish at RTS games. So it all flows. I like playing them, but I'm terrible at them. So let's just start, shall we? And make a complete fool of myself. Right. So. Here we go. So I am using a six-button controller, which is an official six-button controller, not a knockoff. It's an original one, but I don't need the six buttons. I just prefer using this controller. I don't know why. Even when I don't need it, I just prefer to use it. So It is on a Mega Drive 1, by the way. I would show it to you, but then I messed the camera up. It is down. Trust me. It's down here. Anyway, so we're going to start with the basic Mac because I'm rubbish. And I'm just going to try and explain how the game works. So type A. So that's me, the red dude. And I found the buttons really confusing. Anyway, hit C, and then I immediately start building unit. Now, I've watched on the internet what I should be doing, but apparently I'm not doing it right. But I'm going to build him. And you see that spanner there? That means it's building unit. And I pick up the unit, and I'll drop him off at the nearest thing, which is going to be this one. I'll drop him off, and then I go back. As I'm going back, I'll just build another one. And then I'll put it there, pick him up. Hopefully it will do. So what happens is they go into, see the little red dot there? See that little red dot in the base? That's what I need them to fill those four dots. Once they fill the four dots, that base becomes mine. So let's build another one. I need to build four of them. I need to build all these units because I need to take over these bases because then I get money. The more bases I control, the more money I gain. So now I'm going to grab another one. And then I can actually now pick it up from this base because it belongs to me. And I'm going to go to the one in the southwest, just down here, which should be there. And I'll chop them off. And I need more money. Building now. There we go. The infantry units don't take very long to build. Now I have been playing this level a couple of times. I've been unsuccessful in actually beating. I actually find myself at an impasse with the enemy because he keeps on attacking this this base. I need more money. Come on, please. Right, more cashola. Right, good. Maybe I should change it to something else. Try that. Because depending on what you tell them to do is dependent on how much they cost to build. It's a bit strange. That's just the way it is. No, it's still too much. It costs $2,000 apparently. This escalates very, very quickly. It's a bit slow going, but then again that's always the way with RTSs, isn't it? Even the old RTSs would take forever. So I can just build like that. I'm running out of money now. But... there you go. So having three bases like that is going to be pretty good, pretty sweet spot. And that way, and now what I have to do is I'm going to have to build better units. I think I'll build him. Just to defend, because this is a front line. This base here I'm just sitting at now is a front line. It's really frustrating, but there you go. So I'm just going to drop him into place, and I'm going to continue to build. So there's another, I'm going to build another one, because this continually gets attacked. It's really, really annoying. So, I need to do this now, sorry. So I can turn into a robot. Which is pretty cool. There you go, stops down there. So these are like the sentry units, really. So see the mini map down there? He's built three bases, I have built three bases. So we're pretty much an even Stevens. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to build another unit. There you go. So all these icons, you've got to remember them. I mean, eventually you do, but it's like, you just, there's no, because this is really, really primitive stuff. There's no mouse control. It's all based on, you know, yeah, there's no mouse control, which makes life somewhat difficult. So they had to improvise, really. Well, not improvise. They didn't know any better. They were doing their best based on the interface and the controls they had. But it is really, there's a lot to it. You can see my money's going up and up. Is he attacking? He's not attacking my base yet. There we go, I can pick it up now. So they see the OK sign. That's where it's saying, yeah, you can pick up the unit now. And so there's a whole lot of bars there, and they do mean, I actually know what they mean. Energy is obviously what I'm expending now to when I'm moving around. But then there's the G, which is guns. B is the defense of my own base, the main base. And then D is my own defense of my ship. So that's pretty cool. Okay, what I'm going to do is, I'm a bit nervous about Blue Boy. He's going to start bashing away at this base here imminently. So I'm going to build some... I've got some reasonable amount of ammo now. So I'm going to build... No. Come on, Chris. There it is. I'm going to put surface-to-air missile, because he's going to be... He's the only flying unit. So I've got surface-to-air missiles. It's going to hurt him quite bad if he tries to drop anything down here. So I'm going to drop it just about there. Hendrix, thank you, Hendrix has now joined the channel. Thank you, Hendrix. Yes, Greg did probably build the base. Let's build something else. Let's build another Sam, just to be clear. Because this is really annoying. He keeps on having a go at this base, and it's just driving me crazy. So I'm like, fine, I'm just going to... So, here we go. There he is, look, told you. What did I say? So I'm going to have a bit of a fight with him. And he's blown up one of my tanks. Not impressed. There you go. Oh, what's this? Oh, it's a little dude. I don't think so. Right, shoot him in the face. He's trying to get round some boulders. As am I. There we go. Shot him in the face. Excellent. So let's build something else. Let's build another tank. I don't know. This one's a good one. Oh, no. There we go. Phew. It's going to... I'm fantastically inept at this game. So I'm going to pick that up. I think it might go rushing off to the main base. Yeah, it will. I think I'm going to descend it there then. For giggles. Yeah, it's going to... Bloody idiot thing. There you go. Off you go, mate. Cause havoc. Why not? I'm going to build another one of those, though. And, it's still building it. So let's build another tank. And drop him there. There you go. And let's build another one. So we built... So I think that there's a one in the middle there. I'm going to try and take that. See? You can only build one unit at a time. It's really frustrating. It's rubbish. Oh, what's this? That's not on. Hey. There's a little dude in there! No way! Right. So I'm going to build another one of those. Try over to take over that base. Chat's suggesting I use a tank rush strategy. That's just morally wrong, isn't it, surely? It's rubbish. Getting a good number of bases here, which means I'm going to get lots of money. So it's kind of escalates really quite quickly. I think it's the last one for this, and this is going to be a bit of a front line as well. So I've got 10 grand, that's nice. So I'm going to build build more tanks. Build a tank. See, he's at it again. Look, there he is. Look, hey, again. I'm going to pop over there because I'm not sure. Let's see what's happened. Oh, look, there's one there. Die! There you go. It's a weird game. You can see the beginnings of something. But it wasn't quite there. But it's certainly beginnings of something. Oh, great. So the Sam has run out of... See, the exclamation point means he's run out of ammo. Great. Brilliant. Freaking idiot. So what I now need to do is build something I haven't built before, which is one of these supply trucks. Where is he? It's great in this game you can actually see where the other enemy is. So pop him down there. Off you go, mate. Do his thing. So what else have we got? We've got one neutral base left. I'm going to leave that to do its thing. Leave them to do their thing. And then I'm going to build more infantry to take over that other base. Hendrik says I should build a Gundam. I am a Gundam, you idiot! I am a Gundam! Never mind. It's okay, I know Hendrik, it's alright. I know this man for many years, it's fine. Here we go. I can't build another one. I'm getting a fair amount of money. I think I might build a turret over in that frontline base that the enemy keeps on dropping things onto. So I'm going to pop over there now. Where is he? Yeah, he's... I'm building a front. I'm building. I'm getting to a point. I will... Oh, I've gone too far. Oh, this won't stand. Okay, I'm gonna build turret, please. Turret. There you go. Very expensive, but they do a very, very, very good job. Almost at him. Right, let's drop the turret down. Come out! Sod it, he got in. Very frustrating. Very frustrating. Let's just drop you down here. I'm gonna build some more stuff. More tanks, I think. Oh, that's just not on. Needs to blow up the other guy. I keep on hitting the wrong buttons. Oh, they're embarrassing. Okay, let's build more of these. So I'm really hitting impasse. Build another. Oh, we need to go on offensive. Some of these game sessions, a single session can last up to an hour and a half, maybe even longer. Probably not going to finish this, just so you know. I do need to build more. Another SAM, I think. And then I'll get another troop in to kill him out, take him out. Got him! Reroll. Should I just deal with that? I think I should deal with that. Here he is. Got to do it yourself, haven't you? It's a bit annoying I'm stuck here with this thing. I need to defend it a little bit better, or I'll push the front back and then it will stop him from trying to take it. So where's the nearest enemy base? There's that neutral one over in the far right, far left, I should say. Let's go there. Let's try that. Let's push it back further. Okay, let's do another one of those. I think I've already started doing this one. Yeah, I have. One more to go at it. Check me out. So, I'm right just south of his main base. I think what I'm going to do is just throw everything I've got, build loads of stuff on that unit. For some reason, he's obsessed. He's so obsessed. Stop blowing up my stuff. Right. Okay, let's build more tanks. That's not good. I don't know where he's going to go. I think he's going to like sod off. Don't do that. Don't sod off. Yeah, do that. There you go. Just stay there. There you go. And we'll build another one of those. Yeah. Real Sod Crispy is saying I should just drop the hammer. And I think he's right. So I'm going to keep on building some more units here. Because he's obsessed with taking this out. I don't know why. Is it that strategically important? I don't know. He's coming in again, look. I'm going to put some more SAMs. Okay. Put some more up. So I'm going to drop that off. I'm going to let it do its thing. I'm going to have to rely on the fact that I've already blown him up. I'm going to head towards this front line base here. And then I'm going to build some nasty things. Loads of tanks, big tank rush. That's not what I meant. I'll pick him up and then I'll drop him down and then I'll pick him up again and then I'll do this and say yeah. And then drop him off. So it should head north now. So I'll just do a massive tank rush. It's just the best thing I can think of. Yes, I want a neat tip, Sergeant. Please tell me what. Give us a dip. Tank rush. I am tank rushing now. I'm building as many tanks as I can. From this frontline base. His base is taking hits as I'm sending them up. I've got the monies. Work it out. I'm quite proud of myself. I'm actually trying to figure out this game. Oh yeah, he's not happy. He's not happy with me now, is he? Look. Nice. Nice moves. Slick. I approve. It's what I would have done. What I would have done. Enough of that nonsense. It's what I would have done. Okay, let's build more of these. Because I ain't missing. Yeah, he's not having it, is he? He's not impressed with my strategy. He's not impressed. I'm not impressed with it either. Yeah, he's on the back foot. He knows it is. It's not good. Okay. So let's build some stuff that will actually stop him from messing me up. Let's pull some sands. So if I establish a base here, then I might, you know, defensive position and he'll sod off. I'll build another one. There we go, another one. And then we shall build supply, because they're going to run out of ammo, because they're going to fire so many missiles. It's getting fascinating. Got him! I really wish you'd... Oh yeah. Let's drop that down and then drop, build another Sam. Because that worked out so well. So it's all based on like weird icons and stuff. It's just, you just have to figure out, you have to memorize everything. Because there's no tooltips or anything like that. They couldn't do that. It's all based on icons. It's genius really. Okay, let's build tank. On. Right, so now let's build the tanks that that front line, it's, he loves attacking that base, but it's not gonna happen. Not gonna happen. It's not good for him, is it? It's not looking good. It's got to be said. I like the idea of dropping a turret on there. It's good. I like that idea. I might do that. I have the cash. Look at all the money I have, it's ridiculous. Right, okay, so let's build a turret. I like that idea. That's genius. Takes a while to build those. Oh, we're at the halfway mark. And the regular viewers will know at the halfway mark on the stream, I always reveal what the next game is going to be. And that game is Fantavision on the PS2. Don't ask. I just thought it'd be a good idea. Why not? Nope, can't seem to make much dent on it. So I'm going to build loads of tanks now. Just build loads of tanks, pick them up and then drop them in. Yeah, I thought I'd do a PS2 game next week. Because, you know, why not? Let's just drop this tank down here. Actually do a proper tank rush this time, because I'm finding this session I'm really figuring out the interface. I'm not figuring out the strategy though. But yeah, build four. It's the classic grunt rush thing, isn't it? Tank rushing. It's just so dishonest. I bought this game years and years ago, knowing that it was like one of the earliest RTS games. But I'll just build one more. I'll build one more. Yeah, he's not happy. I think he's kind of sequestered himself into the main base. So I'm gonna pick him up. Oh, he's built stuff. Loads of Sams as well. He's not playing fair. Dear. This is war of attrition, everyone. I have to figure something out. I think I might have to squeeze him. Yeah, I'm not sure if I can actually squeeze him, really. Let's have a look. What's going on up here? Is that right in the middle there? Okay. Weird one in the swamp. He's really defended that other place now. It's ridiculous. So I'm going to drop stuff off here instead. What? Oh, sod it. Something else. I've got a supply truck there. I don't know what went on there. Here you go. In you go. I think I'm going to blow up. I'm going to blow up. I'm going to blow up. Oh, close. I'm not going to win this one. There you go. More infantry. I mean, I'm not sure what to do. A bit of an impasse. I can't push up because I tried that. It didn't work out too well. I could do another track. I'll try the Tank Rusher in, because that seems to be the way to go. I'll push up again. Is that another dude? Build more tanks of it. Riveting watching, isn't it? I just not so well. Oh, complete impasse. Complete impasse. He's having a go at something. I'm not sure what he's shooting at, but it didn't work out too well for him, obviously. Again. Technically, I am winning because I've hurt his base. He hasn't actually hit my base at all. Yeah, so Fan Division, that'd be fun. It's been probably a couple of decades since I played. No, I can't be that long. I'm only 17 years old. But yeah, it was a launch title on the PS2. And it's meant to be quite, you know, pleasing to sort of like meditate out to it. It's fireworks, apparently. Anyway, here we go, we've got that. And is that enough? Is that enough? Do you think we've got enough? Let's try that, shall we? Let's just drag one up. Let's change its thing to that. Then it says drop one behind the base. He's built a lot of sands, hasn't he? Drop one behind the base. I'll try that. Because, you know, what's the risk of... Yeah. So, yeah, what happens if I do blow up? Yeah, that. Big deal. Oh, dear. How sad. Never mind. Charge this up. So yes, it's an odd interface. We have to pick up each unit individually, tell it what to do. And drop it off. It's just not gonna work, is it? It's not gonna work. No matter how many things I throw at it, it's not gonna work. Interesting. I'm really at an impasse. Look, I was just like, don't know what to do. That was stupid. think I'll put in... I'll put in a turret here, why not? Completely stuck. It's like Noughts and Crosses. It's like the worst game of Noughts and Crosses. And it's just a complete tie. I'll build another one of those. I've got so much money. That's not a problem. Resources isn't a problem. I think I'll build another one of those to drop on his base to see how much I can mess it up, but still after that. Okay, I'm going to drop this on his base in a vain attempt to mess it all up. Just look at all those SAMs he's got after this. All those missiles, this is really nasty. let's build... No. Fine. Send in more tanks. Loads more tanks. Be here all day. It's ridiculous. Now, I watched a couple of videos on YouTube, to get some tips on how to play it and stuff. And yeah, people play it like competitively and stuff. Really, it's just not working. I can't get enough units. That's a god. It's an exercise in futility. It's just he won't move. He's not gonna budge. I'm not gonna budge. I think what I'll do. He's old, yeah. Silly. another sand. I'll make another sand. Because it's a complete impasse. It's like a complete stalemate. So I need to squeeze his resources, I think. That's what I'm going to do. It's going to squeeze his resources. So let's do that. Okay. Whoa! Where are you going? No, that won't work, no, oi, no, they'll end in tears, wait, where are you going, no. Wayward. There you go, right, I'm going to go over here now. Ooh. You're handy. Whoa! What should we build? We need a support vehicle, don't we? Because that one's blowed up. Thank you. Support vehicle seems to have gone mad. That's great. Thanks for that. Nothing but love for you right now. Let's see if I can take over that base. Because I've run out of ideas, quite frankly. Build another one. My idea is to push his, squeeze him down, so he's only got one base left and he runs out of money. That's my plan. It's probably not gonna work. But this has been a fascinating experience, that's for sure. You can definitely see it's one of the earliest RTS games. I think they had no idea what they just made here. That's the thing. I don't think they had any idea. Yay! And it goes over to me, and then I'm gonna build a freaking Sam. He knows what I'm doing. No, don't be silly now. Let's build another one. Just to really annoy him. This is exactly how I play RTSs. I'm terrible. I'm just terrible. Okay, right. So build another one. Yeah, let's build another one. We build a supply truck because kind of need them. Okay, so he can do his thing, and then I shall build more troops because I don't know how else to play this game, but I'm just going to squeeze him. So Hendrix is asking if the original Company of Heroes is considered to be old enough to be in the vault. Possibly. Oh, that ain't going to work. I'm just going to have him... I'm going to drop him off here then. And I'm going to build more things. More dots. A wall of attrition, isn't it? So I'll build something a little bit heavier. Something like that. So I'm going to go in, drop one of these in. Possibly, Hendrix, we could play Company of Heroes. Haven't done any PC games as yet. But let's just drop it in. Okay, that's pacified. drop those there. He's really hammering that base again. Don't think I can tolerate that much longer. But, we probably won't finish this game in this session, though. Such is the way of things. Oops. Need to do something different. Go. Oh, globbits. Didn't need to build, mean to build that. You can't change build orders either. It's really frustrating. It's not what I wanted. I mean, it's going to be handy in the future, but it's not what I wanted. Got one more to do, haven't I? Okay, I'll go and grab him. Right, I'm going to go do some maintenance now. Oh, he took it! Really annoyed about that. That's not on. That's just... He was obsessed over that base. And he took it. Fine. Singularly not impressed. Not impressed at all. I don't know why I was obsessed with that base. Right. Tank rush it. Because that. That's not fun. It keeps on switching. Pretty frustrating. Yeah, he's got me. He's got me. Really has got me. This is nasty. It's exactly why I did it. Oh, I thought I had him. Just couldn't. Oh. Nothing I can do. Oh, what an ignominious end. Terrible end. Terrible end to this. Yeah, he won. Fair and square. Well done. Well done. My ineptitude really demonstrated itself. I just couldn't get over. But there's some stats here. 41 minutes and 53 seconds I played that for, apparently. Oh dear. But that's it. Thanks very much for watching. That's a sad end, but I really was getting into that. I just couldn't push through. I couldn't see how a way of pushing through. It's definitely a game that requires a lot of repeat play, and also someone who has a better strategic mind than I do, which I do not have. But yeah, thanks for watching. Next week we'll be doing Fantavision, and there might be something else on a Friday evening. We're talking about it internally about whether we should do that. But we might be doing streaming modern games or games yet to be released, like early access and that sort of stuff. Of course, even outside, you know, when we get within the embargo. Thanks very much for watching. We'll be back next Sunday at 8 p.m. British Summer Time to play Fantavision on the PlayStation 2. Bye.